today my objective is to tell you about the algorithm and flowchart, how to design the algorithm and flowchart, okay, for the basics of any programming, and what is the software that we are generally preferred to design a flowchart. So one very interesting and very popular, most widely used software for designing the flowchart, and not only designing and analyzes the flowchart as well. Okay, by the help of that software, we can design and analyze the flowchart. The software name is Raptor. Okay, R-A-P-T-O-R, Raptor. Okay, so I will show you. Everyone must install the software. The software is freely available. It is downloadable and freely available, and very small software in size. You can easily download in any machine and you can use it. Okay, but it gives you a very good flavor, very good essence to how to handle a flowchart and how to analyze the flowchart. Okay, so let me share my screen first. So before I'm going to discuss about the those software, I want to discuss about flowchart and algorithm. So this is the website that which I have already shared with you. Okay, in your Google, in your WhatsApp group, I have already shared the link or URL of this website. This website is majorly done for the people who actually deals with computer fundamentals and C programming. So some part of your syllabus is present here. So if you go at the notes of this website, okay, the notes tab, obviously you will get several tabs here, several buttons here. If you press at the note tabs, you will find a series of lectures, a series of notes are available in the form of PDF. Okay, PDF. Can anyone tell me what is the full form of PDF? What is the full form of PDF? Try. Don't search it in the Google. What is the full form of PDF? Portable document format. PDF stands for portable document format. Okay, this portable document format, this comes in the form of MCQ questions. Okay, remember, portable document format. This is the Acrobat Reader software. PDF software is a part of Acrobat Reader software, and this PDF is generally used for showing the documentation where you couldn't modify the documentations. Okay, without the help of PDF editor, you cannot able to modify the documentation. Okay, but in case of Word, it can be modified. Okay, uneditable or unmodified documentation we can generate with the help of PDF. What to PDF conversion is possible, PDF to Word conversion is also possible. Okay, now in this series of notes, you will find some lectures which is fallen according to the curriculum of your syllabus: fundamentals of computers, algorithm and flowchart. I suggest everyone to read these notes very carefully. These notes are very, very good notes. Okay, very, very high quality are there. So fundamentals of computers, algorithm and flowcharts, and some basics of computers, which I have discussed as a morning session, you can find here. Okay, the various parts of computers, basics of computers. That things I'm also going to discuss in my next theory classes, couple of theory classes, because the basics of computer I didn't finish yet. So those things I'm going to discuss in my coming theory classes. Okay, next theory classes. So in these kinds of notes, you will find the fundamental of computer, these notes. While you will find the fundamental of computers, in that note, you will also find some flavor of how to use the fundamental of computers you will get. Okay, here you will find the introduction part, input, output, processing unit of the computer, memory devices, types of computers, characteristic of computers, history and various generation of computer and applications of the computer. So these are the things which is actually a bunch up into a couple of topics about the fundamentals of computers. And after this, you will find some details about your practical, that like this portion is actually deals with the Windows XP overview. Okay, how you can use MS-DOS, MS-PowerPoint. Okay, some practical scenario, you will get some notes here. Okay, as well as some snapshot. You will also not only get only theory, you will get the snapshots of those kinds of use of MS Word, MS Paint. Okay, now in email and internet, you will find then how to use email and internet, what are the various kinds of search engines are there, searching engines, web pages are there. Okay, you will find out here. Okay, then you will find out the viruses. This is also part of your syllabus, the viruses. What is a virus? What are the various kinds of viruses available? The difference between virus and worms, and then antivirus utilities. Okay, you will find here. Then you will find these three application software, which as a part of your lab, as all of you know that MS Word, MS Excel and MS PowerPoint in detail. Okay. And last one is actually deals with some with some secondary devices, secondary storages. Okay, movable storages of computer system like CD, DVD, hard disk. How to install in Windows, all these things, installation of the Windows, all these basic kind of things you will find out in these notes. Okay, so you will not only find the notes in theory form, but also you will find the notes in taking some sort of snapshots of those generations. Okay, like you will get these sort of snapshots here. Okay, look, the snapshots has been given. Okay, along with the notes. So this is very interesting. You will find it. Okay. Snapshot has been given, okay, for each and every case. Okay. Some shortcut keys. What are the various shortcut keys we are using while we are doing our using our Word document or Excel document, that you will also find here. Okay. So that we will discuss in the next class. I'm just giving an overview of this document. Now, let's come with the discussion about algorithm and flowchart. Then we will see how we can use Raptor to design a flowchart. Okay. Acha, one thing, all of you can search Google for the Raptor. First search it, because it takes some time to install. So first search it.
Yes, everyone. Sir, search it.
Go your Google, search it, download it. Download and install it. Just search Raptor, download for your kind of Windows. Okay, Raptor download, search it in this form. It's a free available software, Raptor Flowchart Interpreter. You can download it or you can download from this link, any link, whatever you want. It's a very small software. Okay, this is the Raptor homepage. It is equivalent to the that Raptor sign of the movies, famous movies. Okay. Excuse me. How many of you have already downloaded it and installed it?
So downloaded it.
Okay. And put it into the installation. Prottek download koro ebong installation e rekhe dao. Rekhe, then you can return back to my lecture. So while you will listen my lecture at the back end, it will automatically download it. Okay. It will take very a few minutes to download. Okay. So what is Raptor? Raptor is a flowchart based programming environment. Okay. Designed specifically to help students visualize their algorithms and avoid syntactic baggage. Raptor programs are created visually and executed. Raptor, ei Raptor ta West Bengal e kothao shekhano hoy na. Okay, I am giving you a very very famous thing, because in most of the good universities are following Raptors. BITS Pilani, BIT Mishra, if you follow their curriculum, they have Raptors. Gitam University, AKL University, if you follow all these good universities' curriculum, it follows Raptor. So Raptor in the West Bengal kono university ba college shekhano hoy na. Okay, but I want that you people should know this. Okay, I prefer my students to know about the Raptor, and it's a very easy thing, very easy to handle. But right now you don't need to know the very details about the Raptor, because to know about the very details about the Raptor, you have to know some basics of the C programming. Okay, so shei tuku dorkar nei tomader ei muhurte joy tuku dorkar. I will just making to deal with that thing. Okay, and it's very easy. You don't need to know any programming, because this is a design drag and drop software, plug and play, drag and drop. You will drag and you will drop it. Okay, drag and drop software. Okay, just like this. This is the after installation, when you will open the Raptor windows, you will get this one. Okay, not this one. This one the user has been created. This figure at the right hand side, the user has been created. You will not get this one. You will get a blank white window at the right hand side, and only left hand side you will get these symbols. And what are the usefulness, what are the specification of these symbols, that I am going to discuss one by one. Okay, but that is mainly majorly represented the representation of the flowchart, the design part of the flowchart. And here we are going to discuss about the algorithm first and then flowchart. Please remember the sequence to know algorithm, flowchart and programming in such a way. Some of you are telling that first you will have to learn program, then you have to learn algorithm, then you have to learn flowchart. Some of you are telling that first learn programming, then flowchart, then algorithm. Okay, so if different people are telling different kind of thing, but believe me, first the rule is to learn first the algorithm, then followed by flowchart, then followed by programming. Algorithm followed by flowchart, followed by programming. Obviously, there must be some reason why we will follow this sequence. There must be some reason. The reason is that programming can be in any platform, in any programming language. Okay, so you may learn C, you may do Java programming, you may do .NET programming, you may do Python programming, any kind of programming you can do. So programming and their syntax are different while you are changing your languages, right? But programming is actually compiler specific or syntax specific or programming language specific, right? But algorithm and flowchart, these are not compiler specific or language specific. This is general for every programs. For any programming language, the same algorithm and same flowchart will be followed. What I'm trying to say, do you understand? For any programming language, same algorithm, a similar kind of flowchart will be followed. Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
Why the sequence will be followed?
Yes, sir.
So algorithm and flowchart are the general representation of any kind of problem, a general solution representation of any kind of problem. And programming is syntax oriented representation. That means for C programming, their syntax are specific to C programming. For Java programming, the syntax are specific to Java programming. For Python programming, the syntax are specific to Python programming. So, protect programming, if you want to know the different programming languages, you have to be expert on that programming language. You have to be familiar with the syntax of the programming language. But for algorithm and flowchart, you don't require any sort of expertise. Okay, anyone can do it. And that will be same for all kinds of programming languages. Okay. So algorithm, what is algorithm? So algorithm can be defined as a sequence of activities to be processed for getting desired output from a given input. So let me tell you a very simple way that there are three major points that we will learn about the algorithm first. The first thing is that algorithm is a finite set of step-by-step instruction. Listen very carefully. Finite set of step-by-step instruction. I'm giving a real world example to clarify your concept. Don't worry. Algorithm is a finite set of step-by-step instructions. First. Second, it has specific input and specific output. Okay. Means it to create an algorithm, the objective is to get a desirable output from a given valid input. Okay. Finite set of step-by-step instruction, which has input and output. Okay. Valid set of input, and you will get a desired output from that input and output. Okay. So these are the important points to describe an algorithm. So what is algorithm? Algorithm is nothing but a finite set of step-by-step instruction in which we will get a desirable output from a given valid input. That is the very basic definition of algorithm. Now the thing is that some of you are asking a question or are trying to ask a question that said, why we require to learn algorithm, flowchart, programming, all these type of things. Very simple. To get a solution of a problem, we will require the help of algorithm, flowchart, and any sort of programming language to get a solution of a problem. Let me tell you the problem first. Okay. Let me tell you the problem first. Suppose I am living in, I am telling you from the real world point of view. Okay. From real life problem. I am living in a Ruby. Okay. Ruby Anandapur. In that locality I am living in. So I'm coming from Ruby to Agarpada. So what is my source and what is my destination? My source is Ruby mode and my destination is GIST University Agarpada. Right? That I will have to cross each and every day. That I will have to travel each and every day. Right? Now from Ruby, I will have to first pick up in a bus. Okay. Hire a bus and then I will reach at the Uttaranga station or Bidhan Nagar station, And from Biranagar station, I actually used to board a train. Okay, and to reach the Agarpada station. So my entire journey is comprised into two steps. First bus from Ruby to Ultranga, and then from train from Ultranga to Agarpada. Right? So my input of this entire scenario is me, means I am coming. So I am the input, I am the object that needs to be transferred from Ruby to Agarpada, this university. And the second is the source and destination. These are the two inputs. Okay, me and source and destination. Source is Ruby mode and destination is Agarpada. These are the two inputs of my problem. And what is my problem? My problem is traveling. How can I travel from Ruby to this university, Agarpada? That is the problem. Okay. And I have already told you the solution. What is the solution? I have to first board a bus and then board a train. So the problem, if I will write this problem, this real life problem in this way, suppose problem is I used to travel from Ruby to this university, Agarpada. That is the problem. How can I reach? Okay, that is the problem. What will be my way? What will be my way? Okay. Now, what is the input of this problem? Inputs are I. Okay. And I means I have to travel from the Ruby to this university, Agarpada. So I is the problem, and source and destination. That means Ruby and Agarpada. From where to where you want to transfer? From which area to which area you want to travel? These are the inputs. Okay. Now solution. Now this solution I have to write in the form of algorithm. Try to clear it. The solution of this problem I have to write in the form of algorithm. Now, what is the first characteristic of algorithm? So these are the characteristics. Let me tell you the characteristic of algorithm. The algorithm has total 5 characteristics. Characteristics. What are the characteristics of algorithms? The first characteristics, finiteness. Second characteristics, definiteness. Third characteristics, input. Fourth characteristic hocche output. And the last characteristic hocche amader effectiveness. Please remember these 5 features or 5 characteristics of any algorithm. Any kind of algorithm must follow these 5 characteristics or 5 features. What is finiteness? Finiteness means algorithm should be finite in nature. That means each and every algorithm must have a start and must have a stop. Infinite kono concept hoy na. Not in programming. Dekho, in case of mathematics, there is a concept of infinite. Mathematics infinite concept ache to. In binomial exponential series, there is an infinite series, if you remember. So in the mathematics, there is a concept of infinite. But in algorithm, there is no concept of infiniteness. Algorithm is always finite in nature. That means there must be some start and there must be some end, or start and stop. Okay. So that's why this finiteness term must be needed along with the features of the algorithm. Next is definiteness. Definiteness means the algorithm should be unambiguous in nature and should be clearly understandable. Clear and concise and unambiguous. In unambiguous means there should not be any ambiguity present inside the algorithm. Ambiguity means kono confusion. Aki problem e dukhana tinkhana solution jeko erokom na thake. There must be one compact and concise solution. Okay, no ambiguity will be present. Okay, which may be confuse you. Okay, third, input and output, which I already discussed. Okay, so what is the input? This is the input. What is the output? Output of our code, reach this university, Agarpada. That is the output. Reach this university, Agarpada. So this is the problem, that I used to travel from Ruby to this university, Agarpada, but I would like to travel from Ruby to this university, Agarpada. And how can I reach and what will be the way? Okay. How can I reach and what will be the way? বুঝতে না পারলে বলবে, ইফ ইউ ডোন্ট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড প্লিজ টেল মি। হু ইজ নট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং দিস? Up to this, is it clear? Up to this, everyone, is it clear? Who is not understanding
this?
Yes, sir.
Please don't. If you yes, don't, I'm online, so I cannot read your face. Okay, believe me, I cannot read your face. I cannot understand what from your output that whether you will understand it or not. So if you don't understand, please ask me. Is it clear to everyone? Shall I continue?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. Okay. So this is the problem, real life problem, and this is the input and this is the output, right? Now, what is the solution? So first solution, that the solution of algorithm that I actually write this solution in the form of algorithm. So solution can be written in three form, either algorithm or flowchart or programming, but always the starting form should be algorithm, next form should be flowchart, and the third form should be programming. Okay, that is the rule. Now if I will write down the solution in the form of algorithm, then I will have to follow these five characteristics. The first two characteristics I have already discussed, 3 and 4 that I have already discussed, which you understand from this problem. First two I have discussed, finiteness and definiteness, and the last one is effectiveness. What is effectiveness? Very simple. Effectiveness, this feature only is not present in case of programming. Flowchart, programming, all are following these features, all these five features. Flowchart follow all these five features like algorithm, but programming follows only the first four features. A feature ta programming follow kore na. This feature effectiveness does not follow by any programming language. Only algorithm and flowchart will follow this feature. And rest of the four features will be followed by all the programming language, flowchart as well as algorithm, right? So effectiveness, what is effectiveness? Effectiveness is very simple, that algorithm and flowchart can be written, which I already discussed in the morning class. Algorithm and flowchart can be written in any place at any time with the help of pen and paper. You don't require any kind of machine, any kind of processor, any kind of compiler to write your algorithm and flowchart. It is pen and paper writing, so it can be easily movable from one part of the another part. Okay, programming, if you want to move a program, that you have to carry your own compiler with you. But if you want to move an algorithm and flowchart, you don't require your compiler, you require only the pen and paper to move. So you can remember it, you can write it, or you can write it, you can move only in the form of paper. Okay, so this is the feature called effectiveness. I think all the five features are clearly understandable by you. Okay, so all the first four features has been supported by algorithm, flowchart, and programming. Okay, the last features only does not support by programming. Only flowchart and algorithm support the last feature, effectiveness. Okay. Now coming back to our real life example. So problem I have given, input I have given, output I have given. Right. One thing you should remember: whenever you want to write any algorithm or any flowchart or any programming, your input, output, and objective of your program should be clear. Input, output, and objective of your program must be clear or should be clear. Otherwise, you are not able to write the algorithm and flowchart or programming of that corresponding problem. Input, output is clear na thake, you are never ever able to write any programming, any sort of algorithm, any sort of flowchart. Okay. So here, input, output is clear. Problem is clear to me. Objective is clear to me. Now, algorithm. How can I write? Try to understand step by step. So I am writing the first step. So I prefer to write this step as step 1. Okay. Step 1. Step 1 will be a start. Okay. This is compulsory for each and every writing, each and every algorithm. Whenever you will write, the first step will be the start step, and the last step will be the end step. Or first step will be the begin step, or last step will be the end state. Okay, as per your choice. Now step 2, what is step 2? Input of your problem. What is the input? I and source and destination. So I and source and destination. So I and source equal to Ruby, and destination equal to জিস ইউনিভার্সিটি আগরপাড়া। ওকে, দিস ইজ মাই স্টেপ টু। So step one is a starting of an algorithm. Step one indicates that it is a start of an algorithm, right? Step two indicates what are the inputs of your algorithm. These are the inputs of my algorithm. Step three indicates the process of getting the solution. That means how can we solve this problem? So what is the process? The first step, step three, reach Ultodanga by bus from Ruby. Okay, this is the step one, step three. This is a process step. This is a process. Okay, in which way we can reach? I can reach. So reach Ultodanga by bus from Ruby. Right. Step four. So you can ask me, sir, how we can write these things? Can we write reach Ultodanga by 24 by one bus? Can we write in this way? Yes, you can also write it. So the language of the algorithm, it depends upon the algorithmist who writing the algorithm. The algorithm likhe take bola hai algorithmist. Okay, who is writing the algorithm? The language of writing the instruction of the algorithm is totally depends upon him or her. So you can change anything in this language, but one thing you should remember, that your objective should be intact, your input output should be intact. Okay, but you have to follow these five characteristics. That also you have to remember, these five characteristics. The first characteristic I have followed, that step by step instruction. So step one, step two, step three, step four. Okay, and second characteristic, that each and every algorithm must have a start and end. End time pore likhbo after completion of this step. Second process, reach Agorpara from Ultodanga by train. Okay, so you can use train number, you can use the name of the train, the destination of the train, you can use it. Okay, your choice. Now step five, by walking I can reach this university from Agorpara. Now step six. This is the end of process. Ami pouche gechi Agorpara. This university I have already reached. So there is nothing left in this algorithm. So we will stop our algorithm here by writing the stop statement. So start, stop, or we can write begin, end. The same thing. Any one thing you can write. Either begin, end, or start, stop. Do you understand? Who has a problem? Tell me. If you have any problem, please tell me. Do you understand it? Tell me, who has a problem? Kar problem ache bolo.
Sir, no problem, sir.
Sir, no problem.
Understand no it problem, clearly? Sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So this is a very real life example. Obviously, this type of problem will not be given in your examination. They will give some sort of a mechanical problem, some sort of common problems. Okay, but this problem is required to understand how to write an algorithm in a first way. Now let me show you what type of problem used to come in the examinations, and the problem generally written in the form of symbols. Okay, the solution generally written in the form of symbol, like in addition you will use plus symbol, minus symbol, star symbol, slash symbol, and this arrow symbol for assignment. Assignment means, suppose we will perform the equation a equal to x into 3. The instead of equal to, in algorithm we will use this arrow sign for the assignment. That means the value at the right hand side will be assigned to the left hand side. The value at the right hand side will be assigned to the left hand side. Okay, a will have a value of x into 3. Okay, so these are the common symbols that we are using in our algorithm, right? Now the first problem, this kind of problem is coming. Okay, it used to come in your examination. Find the area of a circle of a radius r. Very simple. Find the area of a circle of a radius r. So what is the input of this problem? the input of this algorithm is radius r of the circle. What is the output? Area of the circle. Very simple. Input output is present in your program, so you can directly write it down. Most of the cases, input output are presently inside the problem statement or problem definition. Okay. Now algorithm. What is the algorithm? Step one. Here they actually omit the step of start and stop, but I suggest you to must write the step start and stop, because algorithm should be finite in nature. So start and stop is mandatory. Everyone must write it, otherwise examiner will deduct your mark. Okay. Start and stop. Then from step two, you will write these three steps. The first step, input the radius r of the circle. Okay. Second step, area implies pi into r into r. That means pi r square. All of you know the area formulation of a circle, pi r square. So pi into r is implies to area. So the value of the pi into r has been stored where? Within the area variable. So we'll simply print the area variable by using the print statement, print area. Okay, you can also use output word instead of print statement. So I'm again telling you, these internal words can be changed according to your choice. These internal words can be changed according to your choice, but the objective of the solution should be intact. Objective kinu change hobe na. Okay, objective is that calculate the area. How we are going to calculate it? By using this formula. So that objective should be intact. Okay. Write an algorithm to read two numbers and find their sum. Read two numbers and find their sum. Read means input two numbers. So what are the inputs of this algorithm? Input is read first number, read second number, because two number bole ache. So read number one and read number two. Num one, num two means number one and number two. First number, second number. Okay, these are the inputs of our algorithm. What is the output? The summing of those two numbers. That is the output of our algorithm. Very clear. Input output is clear. Problem is clear. Objective is clear. Now start with the algorithm. This is the algorithm. Step one, start. Step two, read or input the first num one. The first two step, we will take input of num one and num two. The first number and second number, num one and num two. Then the step four will give you the addition formulation. Sum implies num one plus num two. So we'll add the two values that we have taken input from the previous two steps, num1 and num2, and added that number and stored it into another value, another variable called sum. And that sum has been printed here, print sum. Okay, and then end.
So?
Yes.
So is it necessary to input the two numbers into separate steps? Can't we do it in the same step?
Yes, no. Oh, that too. In the same, yes, you can do it. You can do it into the same step. You can do it, no problem. It is not necessary to give the input of these two number in two separate steps. Is it clear? It is not necessary.
Yes, sir.
You can do it. It is optional. You can do it. You cannot do it. It's your choice. Okay. But input is necessary. You have to give the input. Otherwise it is wrong because again comes into the feature of algorithm. Features are kya chahiye? Input, output. So these features should be maintained while you are writing your algorithm and flowchart. Anyone has any objection, any doubt, any question up to this, you can ask me.
No, sir, no questions.
Anyone else? Any question? So I have already shown you two problems. One is calculation of area of a circle, and another one is summation of two numbers given input. Now this is another problem. Convert temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. Everyone knows the formula of converting the temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. Okay. Yes, we have to write the input and output separately. Obviously, input and output should be separate. Okay. Why? Because in between input and output, there should be a processing step. In between input and output, there should be a processing step. So that's why they have to write separately. Like in this example, if you see in this example, look, this is the input. And this is the output. Okay, so there must be a processing step. So if how we can write this input output into the same step? You cannot write input and output into the same step. It's not possible. It's logically wrong. Okay, if you analyze it, it is logically wrong. Your algorithm should be written in such a way that the programmer can see your algorithm and can directly write their code from your algorithm and flowchart. Look, in the company, boro je company, the big giants, the company gulo hoy, big giants, there are different people are working for different type of task. There are specifically algorithmist scientists are available there in their company who will write, whose job is to write only understand the problem and only write the algorithm and flowchart. Writing algorithm and flowchart means 80% of the problem has been solved. 80% of your problem has been solved. So the main brain job or brainstorming job of any company is available for the algorithmist who is writing the algorithm or the scientist who is actually dealing with the algorithm and flowchart. And programming can be done by any software programmer. Programming is nothing but a representation of that algorithm flowchart into lines of code. So any expert in a particular programming language can write that code and represent that code in front of the user. Okay, so that's why you have to logically understandable before writing the algorithm flowchart. You have to logically understand the problem and understand the solution, and then the rules that you have to follow in terms of algorithm and flowchart. That rules must be followed. These five characteristics of algorithm must be followed. Otherwise, your algorithm is wrong. The examiner will deduct your marks. Okay. So step one, start. Step two, read the temperature in Fahrenheit F. Step three is that you are assigning the value of 5/9 into F32. That is the formula, as all of you know that. Suppose the formula, I think the formula is wrong here. Formula bhul likheche.
So F-32.
This should be F-32. Okay, there is a printing mistake. I think you have done it. Recognize it. So F-32 into 5/9. And that will be stored, the result, the outcome will be stored where? Into C variable. There should be a C variable must be given. Means the variable name can be anything. Okay, this variable name can be anything. You can use this variable's name. You can use according to your choice. Can be anything. Okay. You can use the entire Fahrenheit word, okay, or you can enter Celsius word. It's totally your choice, okay. And then print the final temperature in Celsius C in step four, and then you will end it. Your algorithm. Is it clear to everyone? So there are three kinds of algorithm.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Very good. There are three kinds of algorithm: sequence, branching, and looping. আমি খুব ডিটেলসে যাব না লুপিং এ বা ব্রাঞ্চিং এ, বাট আমি ছোট ছোট কিছু এক্সাম্পল দেখিয়ে দেবো। আই ওয়ান্ট টু শো ইউ সাম স্মল এক্সাম্পলস অফ ব্রাঞ্চিং এন্ড লুপিং। আই ডোন্ট ওয়ান্ট টু গো ইন টু ডিটেলস বিকজ ইট উইল বি ইজিয়ার ফর দ্য সি প্রোগ্রামিং, দোজ হু আর লার্নিং সি প্রোগ্রামিং, ফর দেম আই এম গোয়িং ইন টু ডিটেলস। বাট ফর ইউ আই এম জাস্ট শোয়িং ইউ সাম বেসিক এক্সাম্পলস, ওকে, ইন টার্মস অফ ফ্লোচার্ট অ্যালগরিদম, হাউ ইউ ক্যান ডু লুপিং এন্ড ব্রাঞ্চিং, বিকজ অ্যাজ ইউ ডোন্ট হ্যাভ দ্য প্রোগ্রামিং ইন ইওর সিলেবাস, ওকে। বাট দে আর থ্রি কাইন্ডস অফ অ্যালগরিদম: সিকোয়েন্স, ব্রাঞ্চিং এন্ড লুপিং। Till now, whatever algorithm we have learned, all are sequence. The first type, only the first type, the sequence, only the first type. Okay, Celsius to Fahrenheit, addition of two numbers, all are example of sequence. Then branching and looping. Branching is generally considered with the help of if and then. Okay, if else, if else, if then. That means if any condition is true, okay, some condition should be maintained. If any condition is true, then if and else. Look, if and then. Look, this is an example has been given. One problem has been given. Write an algorithm to find the greater number of between two numbers. It's also very simple. Okay, you can easily do it. Write an algorithm to find the greater number between two numbers. That means I have given two numbers as input. Which one is the largest and which one is the smallest? That is the objective of your code. So what is the input of your code? The two numbers. So here the input are two numbers, A and B, in step two. Now step three is checking the condition. The condition should be check only by if and then. Ei dutu term kintu tomake use korte hobe. Please remember, you have to use these two terms, if and then, if and then, for the branching sort of things, for branching sort of algorithm. Okay, if and then, right? So if A is greater than B, then C equals to A. If B is greater than A, then C equals to B. Very simple. Jodi A B er theke boro hoy, if A is greater than B, A is the largest, so that's why the output, final output variable is C. So that's why C er modhe eta ke store kora hocche. Equal to jaga tumi ekhane arrow use korte paro. You can use arrow, left side arrow, which we have already used here. This left side arrow we can use. Okay, instead of C equal to A, we can use C, then left side arrow, then A. So A value will be stored into C, and if B is greater than A, then B value will be stored into C. Very simple. Two comparison has been shown in two different steps. Okay, at a single step a likhbe na, it should be written in two different steps. It should not be write into a single step, because these two processes are different. Why? Because first you will have to check this process, If it is fail, if it is fails, then you will have to check this process. That's why it has to written in two different steps or two different instructions. Then a step five, you will print the output variable C. So here in your in this code, either this statement will execute or this statement will execute. Take on actor statement execute code. So suppose you have given value A equal to 50, 50, and B equal to suppose 30, 30. Then which statement will be execute? Tell me. Which step will
step
be executed?
Three, sir.
Step three, yes, very good.
Step three.
So A step test skip ho jabe. The entire step, step four will be skipped. Only this step will be executed, and within C, A value will be stored. That is 50, largest one. And if I give A equal to 30 and B equal to 50, then step number four will be executed and this step will be skipped. Okay. So finally, you will have to print the output variable C and then end. Okay. This is the branching. Branching activity example ko liya, that example ko dokane ami sobi diye dichi. You will find entire thing in my Google sites. Okay, you will go and search into my Google site. You will find this entire thing. Okay, so accordingly you can prepare. This is another example to find the largest value of any three numbers. Tinte number amo the largest. This one was finding largest between two numbers. This one finding largest between three numbers. So three numbers means this multiple condition we have to check, and we have to check by using AND. So if A greater than equal to B and A greater than equal to C, obviously A is the largest. If B is greater than equal to A and B is greater than equal to C, B is the largest. If C is greater than equal to A and C is greater than equal to B, C is the largest. Same logic will be applicable for three numbers. Do you understand this algorithm?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anyone has any doubt in this algorithm? Okay. So.
No, sir. No problem.
Okay, fine. And this one is actually looping. The third type of algorithm is looping. Looping means we are doing a repetitive work. The same work we will be doing multiple times. That is looping. So this is the advantage of any programming language or any algorithm, any flowchart, that we can do the multiple tasks, same task multiple times with the help of a programming. Okay, within a couple of seconds we can do the same thing. Okay, suppose you are I am going to ask you to create a mark sheet or a grade of a student of microbiology. So microbiology contains suppose 30 students. So we will find a mark sheet manually for the 30 students. Okay, who is someone is getting grade A, someone is getting grade B, someone is getting grade A plus. So in this way you can put all the marks, okay, and make it manually. But if I will ask you to do the same job for 5,000 students throughout the university, is it possible to do manually? Yes, it is possible to do manually, but it will take at least 4 to 5 months to do the process, and that process will also be prone to error. Okay, it's a probable to error, prone to error. So that conception will be removed by the help of programming. Your computer program will do the same job for you, but within a couple of seconds without any error. If you do a correct code, then your computer will never do any error. Okay. So this kind of thing can be written in the form of algorithm here. This very simple algorithm is given. What is the problem? Problem is that you have to write an algorithm to calculate even numbers between 0 and 99. What are the even numbers between 0 and 99? Logic ta ki hobe bolte parbe? What will be the logic that we have to calculate the numbers between 0 and 99? So what are the even numbers? 0.
Sir, divisible by 2 ki na dekho.
Divisible by 2, that is one logic. Another logic, divisible by 2, one logic. Another logic is a simple logic. That is, if we will start from 0, okay, always the number which will be incremented by 2 is always an even number. So 0 plus 2, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, and so on. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So each and every time you will increment the.
Yes.
The previous number by plus 2, you will get an even number starting from 0, and up to how much you will calculate, up to 98 we will have to calculate. So the same logic will be applied here. Jeta ami bollam. Okay, another logic she told me that divided by 2, that is also a correct logic. So if this kind of algorithm is coming into your examination, you have to write either that logic or this logic, whatever is suitable for you. So bujhte pachho? So in examination I can give any sort of algorithm to write. Suppose instead of even numbers, I can ask you to write an algorithm to find the odd numbers or prime numbers between 0 and 99. So you will have to write your algorithm accordingly. Understand?
Yes, sir.
So here I'm just analyzing the steps of this algorithm. So first step is the start step. Second step that we have to initialize a variable as I equal to zero. I tends to zero means arrow means I equal to zero. So I have initialized one variable whose value I have given zero. Okay, that is initialization. Now second, write I in the standard output. Why? Because zero should be printed, because zero is also an even number. In this range, zero is also an even number. So that's why I have printed zero as output first. Step four, now zero will be incremented each and every time. It will be incremented by two. So I implies I plus two. Okay. Until how much time it will increment, that depends upon this condition. If I less than equal to 98, then go to line three. Go to line three means here I am actually applying the looping. এরকম একটা arrow আসবে. This sort of arrow, this is a virtual arrow. You can consider it this arrow and this arrow in this way. This arrow and this arrow. Okay, the arrow starting from step five to step three, and reverse arrow starting from step three to step five. So looping will continue among these three statements. Okay. Until it will reach I less than equal to 98. While it will, when it will reach I greater than 98, higher greater than 98 means 99, then it will stop the loop, break the loop, and execute the process. That's why the concept is called looping. Looping means repetitive work, repetition starting from zero to up to 98, and each and every time it will print the output. So in the first case, it will print output zero. In the second case, 0 plus 2 means 2. Now I becomes 2. Now 2 is less than equal to 98. It is very correct. It satisfies this condition. So if it will satisfy this condition, then where it will go? It will go line number 3. So line number 3, again write I in standard output. I means what is the current value of I? 0 plus 2, that means the current value of I is 2. So it will second time it will print 2. So first time it will print 0, second time it will print 2. Okay, why first time it will print zero? Because I equal to zero is the first time. The first time the I value was zero. Second time the I value has been incremented by two, and it supports this condition. That's why it will go to line three. Line three means I is printed in standard output. That means I becomes two right now. It will print the value two. Now the loop is again continue. So it will, after step three, it will again enter into step four. So in the step four, what was the previous value of I? Two. What is the new value of I? 2 plus 2, 4. So the new value of I is 4. So 4 is less than equal to 98. Yes, 4 is less than equal to 98. It satisfies the value. So it will again go to step 3. Okay, so the next value of the I will be printed as 4. Then in this way, 6, 8, 10, 12, and up to 98 it will print in this way, all the numbers. And when it becomes 99, it doesn't satisfy the condition. It will execute from the loop and comes into the step 6. Do you understand? Ke bujhte paro ni? Anyone has any problem? Do you understand? Ke bujhte paro ni?
No, sir, perechi bujhte.
Understood, sir.
What about the others?
Sir,
understood, sir. No problem, sir.
Yes.
Okay. I will discuss this kind of algorithm again in flowchart so you can understand more easily. Okay. So there are some. Look, here the properties of the algorithm has been written, which I have already discussed. Properties of algorithm: finiteness, definiteness, input, output, and effectiveness. Okay. So it has been written. Now comes into the next part, next topic, that is flowchart. Yes.
Sir, you will post these things as PPTs means in classroom, Google Classroom, or in WhatsApp?
WhatsApp, I have already shared the URL of my website. Within the website, yes, in the notes tab, you will find these fundamentals of this algorithm and flowchart. Okay. This topic you will find in the notes, in my notes. In the form of PDF, you just download it and read it. Okay.
Okay.
Go to your WhatsApp group, our common WhatsApp group. It is today I have posted that URL, posted that link. Okay. search it.
And so what about the Google Classroom group?
Google Classroom, are you interested to form a Google
Classroom group? Previously we had.
Yes,
yes sir, we have a classroom for all the subjects.
Okay, okay. Then, okay, then you can, okay, can you join me? Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
But if you join me, can I edit it? Means, can I give the, do some sort of modification there? Shall I allow? Because I was, if you give me a joining permission, then I was, I will be like a user. I cannot be like a owner.
No, sir. You create the group and then you will just give us the code and we will join using the code.
Yes, then I will have to create the Google Classroom. Then you can able to join.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, then I will do that. I will do that. Okay. But I require your mail IDs then. Then how can I... okay, I will give you that the code. Okay, I will give you the code. You will join from your mail ID. Okay. Okay, yes, I will do sir. It. I will yes, do sir. It. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I will do it. And I will also post this URL again in the Google Class. Okay. Okay. So flowchart, as all of you know, flowchart is nothing but a pictorial representation. A pictorial representation of what you have learned in algorithm. Flowchart is nothing but a pictorial representation, a visual representation. Okay. Means how visually you are looking the algorithm, that is a flowchart. So that's why after algorithm, flowchart will be designed. Okay. Now, these are the theory of flowchart. You will read by yourself. And what are the things that we will require in the flowchart? We will require the flowchart. These are the symbols that you will have to remember in the flowchart. Okay, these symbols we are using to draw a flowchart. Okay, what you need to remember, only the symbol you need to remember. This symbol is rectangle symbol, which is called a process. The name of this symbol is process, whose main job is to do actual the process, the mathematical sort of calculation. That means if you remember in case of Celsius to Fahrenheit, the line C arrow F minus 32 into 5/9, that line will be written within this rectangle of the flowchart. Okay. Or if you remember the algorithm of addition of two numbers, okay, that sum equal to number one plus number two, that line will be written within the process symbol. Okay. So that is the job of the process symbol of the flowchart. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Now,
yes,
now input output. Yes, input output means where in the algorithm you have written the input, that input number one, read input number two, or input Celsius, input Fahrenheit. So those things you have to write here in this parallelogram box or this kind of input output box. Okay. This diamond sign or decision sign is made for the if condition. That we have already learned. If A greater than B, that you have to write within this diamond sign. If A greater than B, or if A less than B, or if A greater than B, and if A less than B. So these sort of things we can write within this diamond box. It is called decision. Decision. Okay, the name of this diamond box is decision. It is used for the branching and decision making. This circle is generally connected. This has not a very important use in flowchart. It's optional. Actually, this connector is actually written in such a way. Suppose you are writing a long flowchart. Okay, you are writing a long flowchart in your paper. So suppose after drawing some steps of the flowchart, your page has been ended. So you have to write the same flowchart from the right hand side of the paper. Okay, you have to continue the same flowchart from the right hand side of the paper. So how could you continue? First, you have to add a connector here, give some name of the connector, and the same connector should be written here. That means these two are connecting each other. Okay, so in normal cases, we will actually write PTO. Okay, please turn over. While in the examination, while we'll write, suppose some answers is continue in the next page, we'll write PTO. So this connector is working like a PTO. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
This symbol you don't require right now. Okay, it is for functions and process. It is the symbol we'll require, which will learning the C programming. They will require this symbol. Okay, you don't require this one. This symbol is used for start and end, start and stop, or begin and end. Okay, the start writing, the start word should be written within this symbol, or end word or stop word should be written within this symbol. This symbol is only specific to start and stop. Okay, this one. And the last one is arrow. Obviously, you can understand the arrow means the flow of data, which will represent the flow of data or for the direction flow. That means if arrow is coming from top to bottom, that means your direction of the data flow from top to bottom. If the arrow coming from bottom to top, then your direction of data flow from bottom to top, nothing else. Okay. Let me give one example, a flow chart. You will read this one, the general rules of flow chart. Okay, just read this one by yourself. Very simple. Now let me give me one example of flow chart. This is one flow chart whose algorithm we have already written. Find the area of a circle of using the radius r. This is the flow chart. So start and stop or end has been written within this symbol. Okay, if you remember this symbol, you have to remember for which symbol which process is doing. Okay, don't mess it up. If you mess it up, the examiner will cut the entire figure. Yes, please.
So here in the flow chart, while we are assigning the value of the area to that area variable, we are using equals to. Can we here use that arrow sign to assign?
Yes, you can use either arrow or equal to. Look, and the first time I already told the entire the written thing, the what is the instructions should be written, that entirely depends upon the algorithmist who is writing that instruction. Okay, but your objective should be clear. Okay, and your purpose should be clear. Your input output should be clear. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So you can do it. Start. This is read R. So you can write input radius R. You can also write in this way, or you can write read radius R. You can write it as your own choice. But that R should be used here. Okay. That R variable should be used here. If you give C variable here, and if you write R here, that means it is wrong. It is wrong. Why? Because you have read the radius of a circle with the help of variable R, not C. Okay, so that's why you have to use the same variable for calculation. Please remember, for the calculation pi into R into R, here they have used a direct value of pi. You can also write pi, is your choice. Okay, then it will print the area, the final output of this algorithm, and then end. So data is actually flowing from top to bottom, from start to end. Obviously, in a reverse order, the data cannot flow. Okay, the reverse order is the wrong order. Okay, the top to bottom order is the correct order. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Is it clear to everyone? This is the flow chart.
Yes, sir.
This is a flow chart, sir, which represents the sequence algorithm. Sequence algorithm. Yes, there are three kind of algorithms: sequence, branching, and looping. So this is a flow chart which represents sequence algorithm, the most basic one. Okay, this is Celsius to Fahrenheit, the same concept. I am not going to repeat it again. Okay, the same thing. This is addition of two numbers, the same thing. Now this is a branching, okay, or if loop representation. That means the largest between two numbers, read A and B. Now the diamond sign is using, which I have already told, for decision making and branching, we'll have to use diamond sign, while we can write the if statement. So if A greater than B, so it has two arm or two edges or two arrows. One arrow represents true value. That means if the condition satisfied, then it will execute true value. If the condition does not satisfy, then it executes false value. Okay. So if this condition satisfied, if it executes true value, then which one is the largest? A. If the condition does not satisfy, if it executes false value, which one is the largest? B. So that things has been written, print A and print B, and both the things has been ended with a single end. Is it clear to everyone? Anyone has any doubt in this figure? Very simple.
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
Is it clear by everyone?
Yes, sir.
ওকে নেক্সট দিন কিন্তু করতে হবে আমি ফ্লোচার্ট দেবো তোমাদের কিন্তু ল্যাবে করতে হবে ফ্লোচার্ট ফর দ্য প্রবলেম অফ প্রিন্টিং ইভেন নাম্বার ফ্রম বিটুইন 9 and 100 সো ইভেন নাম্বার দিস আর লুপিং দিস ফ্লোচার্ট ইজ ফর লুপিং ওকে দ্য প্রিভিয়াস ওয়ান ইজ ফর ব্রাঞ্চিং অ্যান্ড ডিসিশন দিস ফর লুপিং স্টার্ট আই 10 equal to 10 ekhane eta bhul likheche this should be I equal to 0 okay it has been mistakenly written okay wrong print
so 9 to
no 0 to 0 to bolo jena 0 to 99 oh acha acha sorry 9 to 100 sorry 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 yes yes 9 to 100 the range has been given so 9 to 100 all the even numbers so obviously 9 is an odd number so it should be start from 10 it's correctly written 10 then it will print the value of I and then it will be incremented I equal to I plus 2 until it will reach I less than equal to 98 but I think this should be 100 okay eta 100 howa uchit tai to because 9 to 100
ha yes, sir
between yes, 9
sir.
And
no, sir.
9 between boleche between boleche ha between boleche between means 9 and 100 out of the range okay it should be out of the range within 9 and 100 so within 9 and 100 means it will start from 10 to 98 it is correct so here a feedback loop has been given look this is the only thing that I need to show here a feedback loop why feedback loop if you remember in the algorithm what I told in the algorithm what was discussed look if this condition satisfied then go to line 3 line 3 mean what this one so that's why in the loop after condition checking it will go to line 3 look after condition checking if it is satisfy if it is yes or no means true and false either you can use yes or no or true and false your choice okay so if it is true or yes then it will go to this one okay actually arrow ta ekhane howa uchit the arrow
sir,
should be here
arrow bhul ache
arrow is wrong please rectify it the arrow should be here arrow should be here after this statement arrow should be here er age statement arrow chole gele it is wrong why because I is again initialized or assigned by a new value of 10 so 12 kintu thakbe na eta 10 hoye jabe abar so it give you wrong output okay so I the arrow should be ended here this loop this feedback arrow this is called feedback arrow this feedback arrow looping arrow should be ended here okay so write I equal to I plus 2 I less than equal to putte ke modify kore niyecho change thik kore nao draw kore nao parle draw it draw it is it okay putte ke draw korecho have you drawn it yes yes
yes sir
in such kind
yes sir
okay so yes, this is sir. All about the theory are ekhane theory kichu porano nei ebar chole ashi ami raptor e okay yes any question yes
so in this pdf the last two flowcharts will you explain one
last two
are they in the syllabus two
last two in this one
so after that problem number 7 that one
this one flowchart for the calculate the average of 25 exam scores this one
no so this one is okay problem number 7 I am feeling a bit doubt
khub details se darkar nahi you don't need to follow the much more details I think so that will be enough that you have to understood the concept of sequence branching and looping that will be enough one or two example will be enough okay
okay sir
okay you don't need to because complex programs
yes,
are also
problem
available
problem one yeah
no don't require such kind of problem because complex problems are available okay so ei problem ta probably the connector dikho dekho ekhane connector example la diyeche look connector is given actually the yes, flowchart is same means the flowchart is continue in fashion okay in this fashion the flowchart will continue so flowchart the page ended here so that's why they have used a connector whose name has been given A and the same connector is represent here to represent that the flowchart will continue from here okay this is not okay, looping sir. This is nothing this is not looping this is not so you are getting confused sir whether it is true or false actually looping I less than equal to 9 yes so if the connector will not be here then the loop will become in such a fashion feedback loop fashion from I less than equal to n it will come in that fashion okay it is they are using connector, that's why it looks complex, nothing else. Okay, you understand?
Yes sir.
Okay. Okay, so Raptor, what is Raptor? Puttake Raptor ki install korecho tomader ki window open hocche amar ekhane Raptor actually install hocche na, that's why the problem I am facing.
Ha sir, open
korecho hocche amar .net framework ta nei kaaj korche na tar jonno hocche na Raptor amar hocche na ekhane. Jok Raptor amar actually barir laptop e ache, but that home laptop is quite heavy to carry. Okay, so ami small laptop ta niye eschi, spare laptop is there. Okay, so tumra install korlei hobe, ami shudhu dekhabo tumrai tomader screen share kore amake dekha dao parbe. Acha, flowchart drawing tool. To flow Raptor, what is Raptor? Raptor is one of the popular tool to design and evaluate projects. Mone rakhbe Raptor e kintu we are not only design the flowchart, we also evaluate or analyze the flowchart. That is also important, very important. Raptor is also used for design or evaluate the flowchart. And this tool is designed to help students to visualize their programs. Okay, so Raptor is simple to use problem solving tools that enables the user to generate executable flowcharts. Okay, which is executed. Raptor is free in nature; it can be easily downloaded, freely downloaded. And these are the key features of Raptor. So student can prepare flowchart. Raptor is a flowchart based programming environment. Student can visualize the algorithms. Flowchart tracing is possible in Raptor. Okay, how you are moving or how you are flowing from flowchart from starting to end, that can be possible to trace in the Raptor software. And Raptor can generate C++ Java code from the given flowchart. Okay, C++ Java code generate korte pare given flowchart theke, seta jana ei mutto dorkar nei. So these are the symbols of the Raptor. Let me clear the symbols first. This symbol, the rectangle symbol, is very much similar symbol of the flowchart, that is process, that is used for the assignment sort of activities. Okay, assignment sort of activities, that means any sort of expression you can write within this symbol, or any sort of value assignment, that means suppose you have given I equal to 0, you can give within this assignment symbol. Okay, this is for call. Okay, you don't require this call symbol right now. Okay, don't require it. Acha, this input and output symbol is required. Okay, you know that input and output. This is actually a looping which you will require for the this is actually branching and decision, if branching and decision. So this you will require for that decision and branching creation. Okay, and the name of this process is selection, and the last one is looping. This one is for looping. Okay, which I have already shown you how to loop the symbol. Now this is an example how to create a Raptor symbol. This is a Raptor symbol example. Okay, okay, let me tell you show you the video first. Everyone look at the video clearly, then I am going to check out the other example. Is the sound audible to everyone of the video? Is the sound of the video audible to everyone?
No sir.
Video sound is not audible.
No sir.
Not audible, right? That sound?
No sir.
Video?
No
sir. Is it audible?
No sir, not yet.
No sir,
not yet. Okay.
File names end with the RAP extension.
Is it audible?
Yes, sir, audible.
Audible, sir.
Okay. Okay, let's start with from the beginning. Listen it very carefully, okay?
Is a visual programming environment based on flowcharts. This video will develop a simple program to calculate the area of a circle and examine some of the basic features of Raptor. The Raptor window is divided into four main areas: the toolbar, the symbol palette, the watch window, and the workspace. The title bar shows this Raptor file has been saved with the file name area.rap. All Raptor file names end with the RAP extension. A typical computer program has three basic tasks: input, processing, and output. This program will start with an input symbol to enter the radius. Symbols can be added to the flowchart in several ways. The first method is to drag a symbol from the symbol palette into the workspace. Now, right-click on the input symbol and select Edit. Each Raptor symbol is edited with a dialog box similar to this one. These dialogs can also be opened by double-clicking on the symbol. The first item in an input symbol is the prompt. This is what the user will see when the program executes. An input symbol also needs a variable to store the value entered. A variable is a named location in memory that can store values. Notice as you type, Raptor shows autocomplete options. The text in a prompt must be enclosed in quotation marks. Press the Tab key to move the cursor and type the variable name. This program only has one input, so an assignment symbol can now be used to calculate the area. Symbols can also be added to the flowchart by clicking on a symbol in the symbol palette and then clicking in the workspace. This is useful when you need more than one of the same symbol. To demonstrate, I'll add three assignment symbols and then click
on. You have to drag and drop the symbol, okay? Drag the symbol, click on the symbol, drag it, and drop it in the correct place where you want to place it, okay?
Undo to remove the two extras. This time I'll double click on the assignment symbol to edit. First, enter a variable name to hold the result of the calculation. Then press the Tab key to move the cursor and type the formula. Notice Raptor has a predefined value for pi. When you have typed at least two letters, pressing the Enter key will insert the selected item from the autocomplete list. After the calculation is complete, the output symbol is used to display the results. The final method of adding symbols is to right-click in the workspace and select the desired symbol from the pop-up menu. The output dialog only has one item to be filled, the expression to be displayed. Text to be displayed exactly as typed must be enclosed in quotation marks. To display the value currently stored in a variable, it is not enclosed in quotation marks. The plus sign here does not mean addition. It means to paste together the text in quotes and the value currently stored in the variable.
It will do concatenation, okay.
The program is now complete and ready to be executed. The play and step buttons both execute the program. The play button will execute the entire program start to end, while the step button will execute the program one symbol at a time, pausing after each symbol so you can view immediate results in the watch window. Clicking the step button once will start execution and highlight the start symbol. Clicking again highlights the input symbol. Notice the input symbol has not yet been executed. The highlighting indicates the symbol to be executed on the next click of the step button. Clicking step now causes the input symbol to execute, which opens the input dialog. Typing 10 and pressing enter sets the radius variable to the value 10. Notice the variable and associated value are now displayed in the watch window. Clicking the step button now causes the assignment symbol to execute and the value placed in the area variable is visible in the watch window. Another click on the step button executes the output symbol, and one final click with the end symbol highlighted terminates the program and shows the results in the master console window. The play button will execute the entire program without repeated clicking. The play speed slider controls how fast the program executes. The last thing to do in this program is add a comment. Comments are added by right-clicking on any symbol. Comments are ignored by the computer when a program executes, but contain valuable information about the program. All Raptor programs should have a comment on the start symbol with the author, date, and description as shown. As programs become more complex, comments should be added to other symbols to clarify the program. This video will conclude with a brief look at Raptor's help menu. Selecting About will show information about this specific version of Raptor, including the version number and publish date, and in case you've been wondering what exactly Raptor stands for.
Okay.
The show log option displays a log.
Has everyone understood it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So So I think you can start. So have you installed Raptor in your machine, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what are the programs we have done today? Write the programs. First problem. These three problems they will do. Three or four problems. The first problem we have already, I have already shown in the video. That is calculate the area of a circle with the radius r. Okay. First problem. Problem number one. Problem number two is taking two input numbers and perform the addition or summation of those two numbers. Problem number two. Write it down, everyone. Exercise. First problem. Calculate the area of a circle with the help of radius. Second, take two numbers as input and perform addition between them. Okay. Addition between them. Yes.
Yes. Sir, I can download the Raptor in my laptop. I can download my Raptor in my laptop because my laptop is not working since few days.
Mobile karo. Mobile karo. You can use your mobile phone. You can use your mobile phone.
So mobile ki kore download korbo.
Oh, mobile Raptor problem. No. Mobile Raptor the mobile doesn't support Raptor. Raptor support kore na.
Sir, amaro kichu problem hocche ki korbo.
Thik ache, jara korte pachho na tara tara hate koro. I mean you can write all those things by your own hand. Write the algorithm and flowchart. Draw the algorithm and flowchart, okay?
Okay, sir.
মানে পেনে করো মানে ওয়ার্ডে করতে পারো বা পেপারে পেনে করতে পারো আমাকে এটা শো করাবে তোমরা
শেয়ার স্ক্রিন ওকে স্যার পেন পেপারে
यस यस
ওকে স্যার ওয়ার্ডে করে নিচ্ছি
আর ক্যালকুলেট এর প্রত্যেককে ছবি তুলো না আমি কয়টা দিচ্ছি যে কটা হয় আজকে করবে নেক্সট দিন বাকিগুলো করবে ওকে আই এম গিভিং দিস ওয়ান বাই ওয়ান সো एवरीवन টেক দা পিকচারস মানে ইউ শুড অলসো ট্রাই এট ইওর হোম ওকে होम जो थे एक्सरसाइज हिसाब तो टेक टू नंबर्स एंड इनपुट सेकंड इज कैलकुलेट फारेनहाइट फ्रॉम सेल्सियस फॉर temperature converter. Okay.
Sir, type hoy nahi to.
Huh?
Ekta bar tumi
hoy nahi.
3.3 theke kichu show korche na.
Cursor dekhaacche na.
Kise bolcho bolo Raptor e?
सबई
टाइप হয়েছে
এক্সকিউজ মি স্যার
ইয়েস
স্যার এই তিনটা যে তিনটা আপনি বললেন ক্লাসে ডিসকাস করছেন ওটা এখনি করে আপনাকে দেখাবো
যে কড়া পড়া করো না তিনটা তো হয়ে যাওয়ার কথা
আচ্ছা
প্রথম প্রথম সফটওয়্যারটা ইউজ করছো তো ইউ মে টেক সাম টাইম ওকে আমি আমি যেগুলো লিখছি এগুলো পড়ো পড়ো ক্লাসে দেখো এই মুহূর্তে দেখানি ওর মধ্যে ক্লাসের গুলো আছে আমি যেগুলো সবই দেবো তো যেগুলো লিখছি এগুলো পড়ো পড়ো ঠিক আছে
আচ্ছা
স্যার ওয়ান আফটার অ্যানাদার স্যার
অ্যালগরিদম
স্যার অ্যালগরিদম বাইরে লিখো
সলি ফ্লোচার্ট তাই তো
ইউ উইল রাইট ইওর অ্যালগরিদম এট হোম এন্ড তোমরা গুগল ক্লাসরুম ক্রিয়েট করে দেবো ওখানে প্রত্যেককে এই অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট গুলো অ্যালগরিদম কম প্লাস ফ্লোচার্ট দুটোই আপডেট করে দেবে যারা যারা দোজ হু আর ইউজিং র‍্যাপটার দে ক্যান টেক আ স্ন্যাপশট of the algorithm of the flowchart with the output take a snapshot and paste it into a word file and add it with your assignments thik ache as a assignment for update kore debo ar algorithm you will you can okay. write either in word format or you can write by your own pen and paper so pen and paper likhle problem hoche you have to again scan it and then update it or you can directly write in a word then it will be easier for you but I need both algorithm and flowchart both for each and every problem okay
Excuse me, sir.
Tell.
Sir, আমি ল্যাপটপটা নামিয়েছিলাম মানে ইনস্টল করেছিলাম পিসি তে বাট ওটা প্রবলেম দেখাচ্ছে তো আমি আরেকবার ইনস্টল করে তারপর দেব আপনাকে
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ করো না ল্যাপটপ যারা পাচ্ছ না তারা হাতে লিখেই করবে আর যারা ল্যাপটপ পাচ্ছ তারা অবশ্যই ল্যাপটপ ইউজ করবে বিকজ ল্যাপটপ ইজ ভেরি ইউজফুল সফটওয়্যার এন্ড ইউ হ্যাভ টু নো দা ইউজ অফ দ্যাট সফটওয়্যার ইন মোবাইলে কিন্তু ল্যাপটপ চলবে না ইওর অ্যান্ড্রয়েড ফোন অ্যান্ড্রয়েড অপারেটিং সিস্টেম ডাজ নট সাপোর্ট ল্যাপটপ your laptop or machine only can support actor
so actor problem hocche excuse me sir
yes tell
so while we are entering something here it's showing enter prompt here so in that prompt box what do we need to write because while generating it there is some error is happening
prompt means when you are double clicking on the symbol you will get a extra window a prompt window in that prompt window you will put the yes, values sir. And those things
so we are entering the variable there is one box written enter variable here and another yes. box written enter prompt here what do we need to write in that prompt
okay enter prompt in the enter prompt you will have to write the variable name you have to write the variable name suppose radius r you will write there radius or rad or r whatever you say the variable name of radius which you are okay. using for your algorithm tumra eta kaj korona youtube e that video which I have shown to you you can side screen ta khulo na video can you can check it the video is very good and it will show very in detail way
okay sir
youtube e just write okay I'm showing it go to videos there you will find a lot of videos there this one I have shown to you raptor 01 introduction okay raptor 01 introduction this video I have already shown to you you will find several videos in that video you will get the idea that how where to put which one so in the prompt I know it because I have already done it so it is your first time to use the raptor so you may face some problem so you can go to that video you can check it and do it okay because I don't have the software right now in my machine so I couldn't show it I have some other problem to install the raptor okay this video raptor 01 introduction okay. youtube okay you just directly write the name of this video raptor 01 introduction on the youtube channel you will find it there. So these are the programs, 11 programs, okay, or you can say 11 algorithm flowchart, which I have given to you. It's the first couple of are very easy, which I have already discussed. And then first five are the sequence algorithm. Six and seven are the branching. You have to use the if condition here. And this last four are the looping. You have to use the looping condition. Is it clear? Is it visible to everyone? Is it clear to everyone? Take a picture of it.
Yes, sir. Sir, when we have to submit that?
Next to next lab, okay? Next to next lab. In the next lab, in the next lab, try to complete the first seven assignments, okay? In the next lab, try to complete the first seven assignments, sequence and branching. And then the next lab, next to next lab, we will complete the last five, four assignments. Okay. I will create a Google Classroom. I will create a link where you can submit your assignments. Okay, accordingly, I will create it. Okay. Everyone must join in the Google Classroom when I will send you the port or send you the request to join. Everyone must join it. Okay, you can try. First seven assignments, I'm repeating again, the first seven assignments, including sequence and branching, you will have to submit before the next week lab. And then the last four assignments, looping, you will need to submit after that lab, next to next week. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So when I'm entering the radius into the dialog box, it is asking for input must begin with variable.
Radius dialog box, input must begin with variable.
Yes, sir. So what we have to do in there, sir?
Can you share your screen? I mean, share your screen, please. I'm giving you the option. One second. Now you can share your screen. Rest of the people do it, okay? Do it accordingly.
Sir, is my screen visible, sir?
Yes, yes, it's visible. Yes.
Sir, Kiyolo. Kiyolo. Enter input. Yes, sir. Here I'm entering the input radius. And when I'm entering here,
input radius, example, double quote mode hobby. Input radius, prompt always within double quote. That writing, input radius. Make it double quote. Always you have to write double quote. Now, video ta dekho, video ta bole diyeche. Now here you will give the name of the variable. Name of the variable. Not this one. Not you are given the value, not value. Name of the variable where you are going to store your input.
Sir,
variable means radius. Sir, give a name, rad, R-A-D, R-A-D, rad. There is a variable name, rad, okay, in your program.
Okay, sir.
Ever done koro.
Okay, sir.
Ever done koro.
Oh.
Okay,
sir.
Now you will have to use this rad variable for the processing. Jokhon tumi formula ta likhbe 3.14 into rad. That equal to area. Sir. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Got it, sir.
Okay. Stop sharing your screen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Atke jabe tara ektu video ta dekho. Dekhe dekhe koro. Tale aro bhalo shikhte parbe. The video which I have already told you. প্রত্যেকে বাড়িতে অ্যালগরিদম ফ্লোচার্টের নোটসটা পড়বে কেউ মিস করবে না ওটা না থিওরি স্ট্রং না হলে কিন্তু ল্যাব করতে পারবে না এভরিওয়ান মাস্ট রিড ইট আচ্ছা আমি রোল নাম্বার কল করছি এভরিওয়ান প্লিজ বি অ্যাটেনটিভ এন্ড গিভ এ রেসপন্স আচ্ছা থিওরি ক্লাসে আমি দেখতে পাচ্ছি কজন এখানে আই হ্যাভ ফাউন্ডেড 40 মেম্বার্স ইনক্লুডিং মি 39 জন আছো 39 39 জন আছো থিওরি ক্লাসে ছিল 48 including me মানে 47 ছিল ঠিক আছে আমি থিওরি ক্লাস যারা যারা আছো তাদেরকে আমি কল করছি ঠিক আছে অদ্রিজা সরকেল
ইয়েস স্যার
আকাশ দাস আকাশ দাস
ইয়েস স্যার
एवरीवन প্লিজ বি রেসপন্স গেট ইউ গিভ ইউ রেসপন্স অর্পিতা দত্ত
ইয়েস স্যার
অয়ন দেব
ইয়েস স্যার
আয়ুষী ভট্টাচার্য
আয়ুষী
ভট্টাচার্য
ইয়েস স্যার
বর্ষা সাহা
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
দেবু
স্যার প্রেজেন্ট
ইয়েস 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 দেবস্তুরি বাসু
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
ঝর্ণাদীপ
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
কার্পুরিকা আচার্যি কর্পুরিকা কর্পুরিকা আচার্যি
ইয়েস স্যার
Kurpurika, what is the correct spelling of your name?
K-A-R-P-U-R-I-K-A.
What is the correct pronunciation of it?
Kurpurika.
Kurpurika. What is the meaning of it?
So, it's actually the food we offer to God, the special food that is called Kurpurika.
ওকে কর্পোরেশন সঙ্গে রিলেটেড নাকি আমি ঠিক জানি না
ইয়েস স্যার উই অ্যাকচুয়ালি অফার দে ইয়া ক্যাম্পো
ওকে ওকে নাইস নেম ওকে মোহাম্মদ সরফরাজ মোহাম্মদ সরফরাজ মৌমিতা পালিত
ইয়েস স্যার
নীলা মন্না
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
নির্লিপ্ত চক্রবর্তী
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার নির্লিপ্তা
হ্যাঁ নির্লিপ্তা সরি পিয়াংশু দে পিয়াংশু পিয়াংশু দাস সরি পিয়াংশু দাস আর উদের পৌলমী দেব
Yes, sir.
যারা থিওরি করছো ল্যাব করছো না দে উইল ফেস দ্য কনসিকোয়েন্স পরে কিন্তু ঝামেলা হবে সো ডোন্ট ডু ইট প্রেরণা জানা
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
প্রীতম মণ্ডল
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
সায়ন দাস
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
শ্রেয়সিনী বেড়া
ইয়েস স্যার
সৌম্যদীপ রাহুত
ইয়েস স্যার
সৌম্যদীপ দত্ত
ইয়েস স্যার
শ্রীদীপ ভৌমিক
প্রেজেন্ট স্যার
হোয়াট ইজ দ্য ডিউরেশন অফ দিস ক্লাস অফ দিস ল্যাব
So 1:30 to 4:30.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Srija Banerjee.
Yes, sir.
Srishti Singh.
Present, sir.
Syed Shahbaz Hasan.
Present, sir. Present, sir.
Kripana De. Yes, yes.
Present, Kripana sir. De. Present, sir.
তুলি এস 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 তুলি মাহাতো তুলি মাহাতো ওকে নাও মাইক্রোবায়োলজি আদ্রিতা বিশ্বাস আন্দ্রিতা বিশ্বাস আন্দ্রিতা বিশ্বাস অবন্তিকা বিশ্বাস
ইয়েস স্যার প্রেজেন্ট
অবন্তিকা বিশ্বাস
ইয়েস স্যার
আলোকান্দা আলোকানন্দা ব্যানার্জি আলোকানন্দ ব্যানার্জি অমিয় চন্দ
অমিয়া স্যার অমিয়া
অমিয়া হোয়াট ইজ দ্য মিনিং অফ দ্যাট অমিয়া
স্যার নেক্টার
ইয়েস
নেক্টার স্যার নেক্টার मधु है ना मधु
अच्छा ओके अंकित शाह
प्रेजेंट सर
वर्षा दास
प्रेजेंट सर
वर्षा दास
प्रेजेंट सर
बिपाशा बाराडी
यस सर
इंद्रक्षी मंडल
यस सर
कौशिक रंजन नेहा मंडल रिया दे
सर प्रेजेंट
यस सर
रिया दे
यस सर यस यस
ओके रितम पॉल
यस सर प्रेजेंट
रितम पॉल ओके शाहिली घोष
यस सर
शाहिली घोष
यस सर
संप्रीत दास
यस सर
Shanondita Sarkar.
Yes, sir, present.
Shopanna Bhoumik. Sujan Maiti. Shubhabrata Karmakar.
Sir, Shubhabrata.
Shubhabrata.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Sujan Maiti, are you present? Okay, everyone do it. Okay, 5 minutes break from my side. Everyone do it. 10 minutes break. Okay, do it.